Despite better conditions in the capital region, Metro Manila mayors have decided to keep the 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. curfew for now. They, however, agreed to expand the capacity of business establishments and religious gatherings. Metro Manila Development Authority Chair Benhur Abalos had proposed easing the curfew hours to 12 midnight to spur economic activity. But during a meeting Wednesday night, mayors said they want to remain cautious for now. They also want to see economic frontline workers or the A4 group vaccinated as soon as possible.
Bro, it's just that gusto pa nila ng another 2 weeks just so ma-maintain muna because nag-presenta kasi itong mga health experts no, na talaga pababa, okay na ang ating mga ospital. It's just that they want to proceed with this very cautiously. They are supporting the MICE. These are, of course, the meetings, the incentives, the conferences, the exhibition at 30%, and the personal care at 50%. They are really for the other businesses aspect, no? So in that respect, kung sasabihin mong about health, balansyado naman eh. Plano kasi na NEDA is that yung workers will be added to those who could be vaccinated, but there will be an express lane for the A1, A2, and A3.
The Interior Department issues a memorandum circular telling village chiefs to hold mandatory health patrols. This is to ensure that no mass gatherings are taking place inside the communities, particularly on weekends. Interior Department Chief Eduardo Año also reminded local leaders to keep an eye on community pantries and ensure that social distancing is being observed.
Nais po nating suyurin ang ating mga punong barangays at barangay tanod, ang mga pook libangan ng sakop ng kanilang barangay, lalong-lalo na kapag ka Sabado at Linggo at holiday o panahon ng pista, upang siguruhin na ang kanilang mga kabarangay ay sumusunod sa minimum health protocols na itinalaga ng ating pamahalaan.
The Philippines reports 5,310 new COVID-19 cases. 150 new deaths were also recorded, but the number of active cases is still at its lowest since March 10. The Health Department notes, while COVID-19 cases in the National Capital Region are going down, other parts of the country are seeing a rise in infections.
NCR from negative 5% na as a low risk nung kasagsagan ay nung April 4 to 17, ito ay nasa negative 47% na po, no? At talagang bumababa. Ang ibig pong sabihin ay bumabagal po ang hawaan o ang transmission ng COVID-19 infection sa NCR at sa pangkalahatan ng bayan. Ang pagbagal ng pagbaba ng kaso na natitirang bahagi ng Luzon ay bunga ng patuloy na pagtaas ng mga kaso sa region 4B at pagtaas nitong nakaraan linggo sa regions 1 and 3. Nagpapakita naman ang Visayas ng pagtaas kung saan region 6 ang may pinakamabilis na pagtaas, lalong-lalo na po ang siyudad ng Iloilo. At ganun din po sa Mindanao, regions 9 and 10 ang may pinakamalaking itinaas habang tumataas rin ang mga natitirang rehiyon.
A group of experts also not in favor of further easing restrictions in Metro Manila and nearby areas yet. It warns downgrading restrictions at this time could mislead the public into thinking the situation has significantly improved. Metro Manila, Bulacan, Cavite, Laguna, and Rizal are under general community quarantine with heightened restrictions until May 31st.
While we believe that we can relax restrictions, well, we think that we should try to retain the GCQ at this time because the cases are still significant. So we haven't, in fact, back in February, we were at 400 cases per day, but we were still in GCQ. So it doesn't seem to be the time to relax to MGCQ at this time. It also gives us the wrong messaging to the people.